sings a little song about three blind sisters. Three blind sisters are also in a tower and are hoping for something that never occurs. So we go now out into the forest. We're in a pastoral, beautiful scene around the countryside. This is a pastoral. Despite being in a castle and having the wherewithal, all that comes with, Melisande wants to leave. She tells the little girl that she cannot live there. She feels that she cannot live in the castle anymore. Golol says, no, you're no longer a child. We're going to make a life here. She stated to stay. Pelleas previously wanted to leave as well. He'd asked at the beginning of the play to leave. The king said no because your father is ill. Pelleas wanted his leave to see his friend of his that was dying. And the king said, no, your father is still ill. Stay for a few more weeks. He stated to stay. So, fate is explained now in this next one with the spinning wheel. represented faith, inexorable movements of what our lives would bring. So Melisande was at the spinning wheel, and in the same room with her, in the darkness, is Pelleas. They don't say a word. She's at the spinning wheel. He's nearby in the room.
Thank you.
asking him questions. What are they doing? They were just standing there. That was all to Pelleas, separate. Eventually, Pelleas cannot stand it anymore. He tells Melisande, I'm leaving. This is my last night. Meet me at the fountain at night, late at night, outside the gates of the So Melisande sneaks out, thinks Lola is sleeping. She meets Pelleas in front of the fountain. And finally, they admit to each other their love and embrace. And they say, it was a love at first sight, they tell each other. Pelleas is ecstatic. He finally hears the words that Melisande tells him, I love you. As they're in their embrace, Melisande whispers to Pelleas, the Lord is in the shadows. Pelleas says, don't move. Lord comes, he has his sword. He stabs Pelleas, kills him, and gives Melisande a flesh wound. The doctor would say later, a wound that wouldn't even hurt a bird, a little flesh wound. Pelleas is dead. Melisande runs off back to the palace. Golol chases her. It's a few days later. Melisande is now on her deathbed. It turns out she was with child. She gave premature birth to a little girl. But that's not why she's on her deathbed. The doctors don't know why she's on her deathbed. She said the wound from the sword would have gone out of her birth. And yet here she is on her deathbed. Now, Belol does not know if this child is his or Pelleas'. He thinks maybe something happened. And he, as she's on her deathbed, Belol, in essence, interrogates her. Sort of indirectly asking, was there anything happening? And she never answers. She's at this point out of it, answers indirectly, and passes. And the play ends below, never knowing whether that baby is his or Pelleas's. The death